So your OCD doesn't let go and you just have to make that layout prettier. And perhaps improve on the user experience while you're at it, as if someone would care. But you care, and that's what's important. It's not too bad, and that's what makes it a good exercise in visual design. It's the little things that can bring the user experience to the next level. That level that makes a product feel more round and professional. But hold on, you say, what is this website even? And that doesn't really matter for this exercise, but since you've asked, it's Modular Grid, a platform for synth nerds where you can learn about all sorts of synth modules and design your own system before you start your most expensive hobby.
Yay!
So you start with a navbar, because the logo is pixelated and it stresses you out. You find the logo online, drop it in XD, add all the other buttons and even out the spacing. You keep it white, because the whole site is white and you're not really sure why they made it black in the first place. You add a little drop shadow and you're happy. Now to the main dish. This block of data informs us on the basic measurements, price, current draw, and rating for the module. It's the one thing most synth nerds would check before buying any module. Unless you're Richard Devin, I guess. But there's only one of him. And so if it's so useful, putting it under the description doesn't really serve it right, because the description can be this short or this long. It's changing in length. And so the designer in you can't help just asking, what if? You drop the page content in XD and separate the data from the description. You drop the data on the right, just under the image. You group that data, because the reader can then find it faster. And this is one of these little visual design tricks that actually affects user experience. You group the dimensions together, you group the current draw together, then you take the filtering tags and put them on top, just under the header, because they're higher in priority if you think about it. Otherwise, why would they be featured on the main page where all the modules are presented? Right? You add the approved by manufacturer sticker on the side too, because it's also quite important, and on long pages it actually gets lost under that block of text. You get that right column in order, not changing much except of some spacing, but then you find yourself spending way too much time looking for a good replacement for that next page arrow, like someone would actually notice. You spend a few more minutes pixel f***ing that layout and then realize you forgot to give the rating interaction some love. On the original design, the rating itself is part of the data, and the rating interaction is this little block at the bottom that doesn't really feel like something I should interact with. And then once I do realize I can rate it, there's no way back. How do I retract my rating? Anyhow, back in XD, you really don't like how the rating module looks, so you give it another try. You add a light gray background for the interaction block, separating my rating from the general rating. Then you actually really like that sentence they use in the original design, so you put it in your design as well. You move things around and you're done. You can go to sleep now. Nah, just get back to your patch. Sleeping is way overrated. See you next week.